This is the Believer's Voice of Victory daily broadcast. Praise God, it's time for Wednesday's edition. I'm Kenneth Copeland, and all this week we're studying the fabulous, great subject of faith. Praise God. I'll tell you, when you realize that God Almighty has given us His faith and tells us to live by its power and its force. I'm telling you, when you begin to realize that, it is exciting, it's thrilling. The more you know about it, the more excited that you get. So don't miss a moment of this broadcast, and in a moment, I'll be back with today's message.
Welcome to a special airing of the Believer's Voice of Victory from 1989. This timeless faith-building message by Kenneth Copeland is from KCM's Foundational Classics series, The Force of Faith. Now here's Kenneth.
Well, praise the Lord. I'll tell you what, let's have a word of prayer before we get into this today and ask God to reveal His best to us about the subject of faith by the Holy Spirit. You agree with me as I pray. Father, we thank You for this broadcast today. We thank You for the Word. We give You praise and we worship You. And we ask You to reveal to us by the Holy Spirit Your subject of faith, the use of it, the power of it, and all the things that we need to know to be better equipped to carry out Your desire in this earth, in our lives. We thank You for it and we praise You for it. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. I hope you got your Bible with you there today, because faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. That's what we read in Romans 10:17. And if the Word says, if that's where faith comes from, then that's where it comes from. I remember as a boy and raised in a church, you know, I mean, my folks in church all the time, I was raised right. It wasn't their fault I turned out like I did. I mean, you know, but I remember things that I picked up along the way. I didn't consciously or conscientiously on purpose ever learn anything when I was younger and in school and in church and so forth. But somewhere along there, I picked up that faith came by all the problems and the turmoils and the tests and the trials and all that. And there's nowhere in the Bible that it says that. And besides that, if that's what caused faith, everybody on earth would be a faith giant. Well, so we know that isn't true. But the Bible said, faith cometh by hearing, hearing by the Word of God. Now, faith is not the product of reason. It is a spiritual force, therefore it is the product of the Spirit. It is a product, first of all, of the Holy Spirit. It's God's faith. The Bible said Jesus is the author of our faith in Hebrews chapter 12. So, if God's the author of it and it's God's faith, God is a spirit, Jesus said, and those that worship Him in spirit and in truth. Now, that's kind of vague and far out unless you study what we did all last week and what we talked about mostly yesterday and Monday, the fact that man is a spirit being. He's created in the image of God. We are a spirit. We have a soul made up of our will, our emotions, and our mind, and we live in this physical, natural body. Now, most of our education, most of our schools, and I'm sad to say, most even of our Bible schools are not oriented in spiritual knowledge and revelation, or knowledge gained by revelation from God's Word, from the Holy Spirit, and so forth, but it's natural, mental, physical knowledge gained by the five physical sense gates. Now, we're going to get into this in detail before we get out of this subject of faith, but right now we need to realize that faith doesn't come out of your mind, it doesn't come out of your reasoning faculties, it comes out of your spirit. Faith is a spiritual substance. Let's read Hebrews chapter 11, where the Word of God tells us, this is where we were reading yesterday, now faith is the substance of things hoped for. Now the Bible said hope will that will not make you ashamed. You say, well, there's sure a lot of stuff I hope for that I didn't get. Well, now this right here could very well be the answer, and most of the time it is, why people pray for something they hope to receive and never receive it. Because hope alone, hope is wonderful. Hope is something given to us by the Lord Jesus at Calvary. I mean, we have our hope in Him. But hope without faith has no substance. It's a dream. It is in the soul realm of the imagination, the dream realm, and it never will come to pass if it doesn't have some spiritual substance to it. And you hear people say, well, we're just hoping and praying. I'll tell you what, if that's all you're doing, that's all you're ever going to do. You're not hoping, praying, and receiving. Jesus said, whatsoever thing you desire when you pray, believe you receive them, and you shall have them. So, faith is the substance of things hoped for. Faith is the supernatural, creative, living life power of God that comes out of His Spirit, that has been deposited in your and my spirit when we made Jesus Christ the Lord of our life. It rises in response to our believing God's Word. God's faith is already in His Word. He believed it when He said it. And it rises to reach into the unreality, non-real world, as far as material and so forth is concerned, of hope, imagination, and dreams, and becomes the subject of that hope and becomes the substance of that hope. And it then is the supernatural power that brings that hoped-for dream, picture, imagination built by the promises of God and brings it into the physical manifestation that we can perceive and hear and touch and taste and smell and all that and so forth. Now, faith is not the product then of human reasoning. It is the product of the Spirit. We found in Isaiah 1:18 that said, we come reason with the Lord. Well, that kind of reasoning is on the Word. We base our reasoning together, our reasoning with ourselves, on our reasoning with the Lord. I don't reason about His Word, whether or not it's true. I have settled it in my heart that it is true. And if something tells me that it isn't, then I stand in rebellion to that, not to the Word. I side in line with the Word. And my reasoning faculties have to come in line with the Word. So that faith, then, has an opportunity to change this thing that I've been seeing that says the Word's not so. If my body's sick and it tells me it's sick, and if I go around saying, yes, I'm sick, God, I'm sick, Satan, I'm sick, wife, I'm sick, child, I'm sick, pastor, I'm sick, body, you're sick, yeah, I know you're sick, yeah, you're sick. Well, all the time that I was saying all of that and reasoning all that out in my mind and going to God and say, I sure do hope to be healed. I sure hope to be healed. Yes, I believe God's going to heal me someday. Wonder why He don't ever heal me someday. Someday ain't here. Well, there's no faith in that. See, I have, by reasoning, decided that what I see is true. Seeing is not believing. Believing is seeing. The world says seeing is believing. They don't believe anything unless they can see it. Well, how can they ever change what they see if they don't believe? Well, you see, that's backwards, and that's just right where Satan wants to keep you. But when you go to the Word of God and say, yes, the Word is so, by His stripes ye were healed. Peter said, by His stripes you are, said Isaiah 53, and Peter said, by His stripes ye were. So, if ye are and ye were, then I am. And I'm speaking by faith in line with what God has already said. Now, my body says, no, I'm not healed. I say, wait a minute. You're not me. You're just my body. And in the name of Jesus, I am healed. And out of my spirit comes the healing power of God into this body. Now, body, you respond to that. I believe I receive healing in you. I thank you for it, Father, in the name of Jesus. Thank God, as far as I'm concerned, I'm healed. Well, now, what have I done? I've agreed with the Word, even if I had to disagree with my body. Now, that is actually a very fundamental of faith, because the Bible said in the 4th chapter book of Romans that by faith we call things that are not as though they were. Now, let's stop right here and back up a little bit and look at this faith as a substance. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen, for by it the elders obtain a good report. Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the Word of God, so that things which are seen, these things that we can see, the earth, the trees, the sky, and all these things around us, including our bodies, because you can trace, I can trace my flesh, my body, back through God's creation to the day that He created Adam's body, which He created out of the dust of the earth. So, God, those, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear, or the modern way to say that would be that things which are seen were not made out of something you can see. It was made out of faith. It's a spiritual force. But the force of faith that you can't see is the creative force of God that becomes and is the seed to those things that you can see. So, these things that you can see can be traced back to the faith of God, because it was by faith God used the substance of faith to create these things. Well, let me ask you something. Doesn't just good sense tell you that if it was made from faith, that it'll still respond to faith? Couldn't it be changed by faith? Let me ask you something else. Will fear change physical things? Oh, yeah. I mean, we realize that, don't we? Fear changes the color of your hair. I mean, there's cases known where, and documented, two or three that I'm thinking about right now, that you can just, if I had time to tell them to, well, one of them was they're out in the river that comes into Niagara Falls. There is a barge out there that is hung up on the ground. It's been there for 30 or 40 years, but the guy that was in it today and hung up didn't know it was going to sit there for 40 years. I mean, that thing broke loose up there in the Great Lakes, and I mean, it started down that river, and just a little ways before it got over Niagara Falls. Boy, I mean, you know, it's all over then. Just a little ways before it got there, it stuck. And here these guys were out in the middle of this barge, and there's the Niagara Falls right there. And they finally got these guys off of this thing. I mean, they were afraid to breathe, brother. They were on there hours and hours and hours. They strung a breeches buoy out across there. And this guy hand walked across to get this breeches buoy set up and got the lines fouled up and had to go back out and start all over again. And these guys are all standing there. The next day, one of them was snow white headed, and he'd been dark haired the day before. When the sun come up the next day, he was so afraid that all of his hair had turned snow white. Yeah. Well, you know what I'm talking about. Can fear make you sick? Well, medical science has already proven that fear and anxiety is one of the most sickly things, causes more problems and causes the heart to come apart, causes your joints to get into stiffness and arthritis and all of that kind of thing. Well, yeah, Brother Copeland, everybody knows that. Well, let me tell you, ask you something. Can you see fear? No, now you can see the results of it. Sometimes you can smell it. Sometimes you can sense it, but it's not something you can take out and feel of it and look at it and say, uh-huh, that's fear. That's what no, you can't do that. It's a spiritual force. Actually, fear is perverted faith. The first thing Adam said when he fell, Adam had faith in him. God invested faith in him when he made him, because it's impossible to please God without faith. Right there in Hebrews 11:6 says that. And he created Adam and said he was good. He was pleased with him. So he's bound to have faith. Well, the first thing that happened after he fell, the Bible said he was afraid of God. He feared God. Before, he had faith in God. Adam didn't even know he had faith. Actually, that is a manifestation of faith. Is, and really, that's the way God wants us to develop and grow, to where we get to the place we just believe God and walk with God like Jesus did, and you really don't see a man being all shook up or rattled about anything. I mean, he just has faith, knows he has faith, never really gives too much attention to it, just has faith. Jesus said, I'll pray the Father, and He'll send you the Holy Ghost. Now, if one of us would have said that, somebody would say, how do you know He'll send? You never know what God's going to do. He might not do it. It might not be His will. It might not happen today. It might happen 6 months later. May not ever happen at all. Nya, 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 nya. Or if it was on the other end of it, we'd say, well, I'll pray the Father, and I'll ask Him to send the Holy Ghost. And if it be His will, He might do it. He might not do it. You never know what He's going to do. I wish He'd straighten up. Oh, no, no. That isn't what Jesus said. He said, I'll pray the Father. He's sending the Holy Ghost. Somebody said, yeah, but that was Jesus. Well, He's given you His name in which to pray. Huh? Now, you see, Jesus walking by faith. He didn't come up out there at the tomb of Lazarus and go back over in the car and say, oh, my God, oh, what am I going to do? Oh, God, durst thou not know that I've come upon this here funeral 4 days late? No, he didn't do that. He just walked in there and said, roll that stone away from the door. And what did the man's sister say? Ah, he stinks already. What does that have to do with anything? Oh, if you'd have just been here, right after he died. Maybe before he started stinking, you might have been able to raise him from the dead. Now, see, that's the reasoning faculty talking. Faith is faith. I mean, he walked up there, and the will of God's had moved the stone away from the door. They said, oh, and he said, listen, didn't I tell you if you'd believe, you'd see the glory of God? He said, I am the resurrection. Lazarus, get up! Hallelujah. If he hadn't called him by his name, I guess everybody in that graveyard got up. But he called him Lazarus and up he came. The point I wanted to make here, Jesus knew who He was in the Father, knew how faith operated. He wasn't asking for more faith. He used what He had. And we've been given the name of Jesus, and the same Holy Spirit that was residing in Him and on Him is available to us, residing in us, and available to reside on us in His name. We can move and walk and have faith in the power of the living God. Hallelujah. Isn't that good news? Now, so faith is a substance. Now then, faith is from God. Now, I want to talk to you here a moment and unravel some things that will and begin to show you some things that you will really need to know as you begin to use your faith and begin to believe God and exercise your faith in your daily life. First of all, let's talk about the faith that we deal with that's from God, the faith that we are to live by. You know, the Bible said, the just shall live by faith. 2 Corinthians 5 makes this statement, and it is, oh, I'll tell you, it's so simple, but yet it's one of the most profound, one of the most in-depth statements in all the New Testament. We walk by faith, not by sight. Sight standing for what we perceive by the five physical senses. In other words, I walk by faith, not by what I see. I walk by faith, not by what I just hear. I walk by faith, not by what I feel. I walk by faith and not by what I smell. Now, faith is, and believing is an action word, and we could illustrate that like this. If you were seated, say, in church, and some guy ran in there and said, the building's on fire! And you said, I don't smell any smoke. I mean, if something's wrong with your nose, you could be a fire before you ever knew it. Or you could say, well, you know, I don't feel any warmer. But now what happens if you believe the guy? You get out first. You act on it first and then say, well, does anybody know whether there's actually a fire in there or not? It don't make any difference, brother. I'm out. I mean, I saw that happen We went into Louisville, Kentucky one time for a meeting. We got in the night before the meeting was supposed to start. And just after we got into the hotel that night, there was a big nightclub and theater in that town. There was a man ran out there on the stage and said, "This place is a fire. Let's get out of here orderly. Get up and go now." And he took off out that side door, and everybody sat around and said, "Ha, ha, 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 ha." They thought he was part of the show. And some of them said, "Well, you know, he didn't smell any smoke." And all of a sudden, the roof caved in on the thing and killed 1,200 people. Just because they didn't believe what that man said. Well, now that's where the Word of God is the man that runs in and tells us, and we act on it in the name of Jesus. Now, Ephesians chapter 2, and let's look at this from the fourth verse. "But God, who is rich in mercy, for His great love, wherewith He loved us, even when we were dead in sins, has made us alive together with Christ. By grace are you saved, and raised us up together, and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus." So the same power that God used to raise Jesus from the dead, He used on you to get you born again, or had you spiritually raised some spiritual death. Now listen to this. "That in the ages to come He might show the exceeding riches of His grace and His kindness toward us through Christ Jesus. For by grace are you saved through faith." By grace are you saved through faith. "And that not of yourself, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. For we are His workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God has before ordained that we should walk in them." That's talking about the new birth. And when you were born again, God placed faith to live by. It's faith you got saved by, and now it's faith to live by every day of your life. That faith right there will provide the food you eat, the clothes on your back, your transportation that you need to function in your ministry and in your daily life. It will provide for your spirit, your soul, for your body. Now, there are other kinds of faith, and we're going to get into that tomorrow because we're out of time today. There's natural human faith that does have to do with your soul, your mind, your will, and your emotions. That's not what we're talking about. There is the faith of God in the gifts of the Spirit, or manifestations of the Holy Ghost, that unto one is dealt the gift of faith. Well, that's not talking about this faith that I'm talking about. That's God's faith that is in the Spirit of God. It is a manifestation of the faith of the Holy Ghost added to your faith in a role of ministry. Praise God.
A mechanic needs the right tool to tune a car's engine. A builder uses the correct equipment to build a strong foundation. Live a victorious Christian life and use your faith the way God designed it. The Faith That Works package will help you get the breakthroughs you need and become the spiritual powerhouse God has called you to be. This package includes the Faith That Can Move Mountains Lifeline Kit, a 10-day spiritual action plan by Kenneth and Gloria Copeland that is filled with practical teaching on faith, interactive devotional questions, scriptures, worship music, and more. The How to Put Your Faith to Work CD series by Kenneth Copeland will help you use your faith on purpose and make your life better, full of peace, health, and freedom. Let your faith soar to new heights and experience living active faith as you read the book Force of Faith by Kenneth Copeland, included free. Your faith is a game changer. Put it to work today. Order the Faith That Works package and receive all three faith resources for $37.99 and enjoy a special savings of 30%. Log on to kcm.org/TV special and request your package today. This Lifeline kit, CD series, and book will help you find the answers you need about faith and how it works each and every day. Develop your faith and walk in victory. Order the Faith That Works package today. For an additional 10% off, order your package online.
The Bible says that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. And if you heard this broadcast today, then you heard the Word, and faith is present in your heart. If you've never made Jesus the Lord of your life, then you have in you right now more than enough faith just to respond to His grace and everything He's done for you. If you've never been born again, then pray this with me. Just say this, "Oh God in heaven, I come to You in Jesus' name, and I receive Your forgiveness of all my sin. I believe in my heart, and I confess with my mouth, Jesus is the Lord of my life. Fill me with Your Holy Spirit. Take my life and do something with it. In Jesus' name, amen." Now listen, if you prayed that prayer, I know it was simple, but you're born again, and the power of God's faith is in you right now. And Kenneth and Gloria Copeland have something that they would like to send you absolutely free. It's just called the Salvation Package. It's a book called He Did It All For You by Kenneth and Gloria. And along with that book, we're going to send you two brochures about how to study your Bible, how to read your Bible. And now that you've got this faith in you, it's important that you know how to use it, how to develop it, how to release it. And these free teaching materials are going to help you understand who you are in Jesus, who Jesus is in you, and what belongs to you as a child of God. So request your free salvation package today. Go to kcm.org. Let us know you want it, and we'll get it to you absolutely free. Also want to let you know that the Washington, D.C. Victory Campaign starts November 13th, goes all the way through Saturday, November 15th. So join Kenneth and Gloria Copeland. They'll be at the Hilton Memorial Chapel in Woodbridge, Virginia. This is very close to our nation's capital. Listen, God is our source. He's your source. Put your faith into action. These are very, very important, very exciting times that we're living in. This is why you and I need to get into meetings like this. This is KCM's last meeting of the year, so come get in there. Put your faith into action. And if you can't be there in person, you can always join us live on kcm.org. Don't miss this broadcast tomorrow. It's going to be a blessing to you. You'll be glad that you tuned in. Until then, this is Jeremy Pearson's reminding you that Jesus is Lord.
Learn more about beginning your new life in Christ Jesus. Request your free salvation package today at kcm.org/salvation. Jesus did it all for you. It's time to receive His love and live the abundant life God provided for you. For additional teaching and free information on salvation, go to kcm.org/salvation. Come to a Kenneth Copeland Ministries event. The 2014 Washington, D.C. Victory Campaign, November 13th through 15th with Kenneth and Gloria Copeland at the Hilton Memorial Chapel in Woodbridge, Virginia. The 2015 Branson Victory Campaign, February 26th through 28th with Kenneth and Gloria Copeland at Faith Life Church in Branson, Missouri. The 2015 Southwest Believers Convention, June 29th through July 4th with Kenneth and Gloria Copeland and their special guests in Fort Worth, Texas. Join Kenneth Copeland tomorrow.
Or in other words, when you were born again, the Bible said any man that is in Christ is a new creation in Christ Jesus. You are His workmanship created in Christ Jesus. That faith was put in you when that happened. That's what caused it to happen. And you were created, you are His workmanship in Christ Jesus unto good work. What works? The works that faith and grace will do.